Yeah. Okay, did they give the .py file in the morning in your solution? Yeah. They did not give you a file, so you need to create a file. So I'll save it saying with tic-tac-toe.py. I created the file and I'll open the documentation. Okay, what is the problem about? What is the problem that we need to solve for today? What is the problem actually is? Yeah, you have a statement over there. What is it saying? Find out the winner based upon the input. Write a Python program to announce the winner for a tic-tac-toe game. Yes, you need to develop a game which gives us a winner. And the name of the game is tic-tac-toe. Okay. You all know what tic-tac-toe game is? Yes or no? Yes. If you want, you can see here. A game, two players will be there. The opponent will be playing. Based upon the inputs, you need to play the game. He will provide the winner and the loser. Yes, that is the game. Okay. Next, what did he give? Did you all understand what the problem statement is? Yes. Based upon the given input, you need to find out who is the winner. Each game, that means each gameplay will have two players, player 1 and player 2. Yes? Okay. Next thing is input format. What does this input format say? Matrix format. Okay. Yeah, which format is the data in? Okay, how can you say it is in the matrix format? 3 into 3. Okay, that means each line you can consider as a row. Each row has 3 columns. That is, the game itself is a 3x3 game. Tic-tac-toe. Yes? The data is stored in the format of, that means the, we have to store in the format of a 2D list and work on it. Yes? Okay. Will the data be given in the format as matrix itself from the user?
No.
Okay, what will be the format of the data given?
String.
Each line will be given as a string. Yes? There are 3 rows given. You need to convert 3 rows of input into a matrix. 2D list, 2-dimensional list. Yes? Okay. This is the input. What is X here? What do you think X is? Yes, one of the players move. We can consider X as the one of the players move. That means there is player 1 Rajesh and player 2 Kranti. And player 1 Rajesh moves are, we can say this particular move is done by Rajesh with the name of X over there. Okay. Now Kranti's move will be represented by 0. Oh, sorry, O. It's an O. Kranti's move will be represented by O. And dot will represent none. That means the move hasn't been still done. Okay. Right. Have you understood how the data is being given from the user? Okay. Above input represents a tic-tac-toe game. Each line is a row with values delimiting using space. That same thing that we have spoke about, he's describing it again. Okay. Below are the possible values for the valid game could contain. Read this statement properly. Below are the possible values that a valid game grid can contain. That means, can we have other data than X, O, dot? Can we have other data? Okay, for example, if other data is present, what you can say? Yes. If we get data other than X, O and dot, we can say that game is invalid. Because he's saying here, below are the possible values that a valid game grid could give, could contain. Yes? Okay. This is of input. Okay. Based upon the given input, who will be the winner? Yes? X. How? The diagonal from left to right. Yes? The same thing he has calculated here. Expected output is X. If you consider that as the input, this is the input given by the user for the game program. This should be your output. Who is the winner? Okay? Right. Here, it represents the winner player. X represents the winner player. After that, based on the game input, there could be following outputs. He is saying based upon the inputs given, the following will be the outputs. X or 0, winning player from the grid. X or 0. If X makes a count of 3 in one direction, it will be the winner. If not, O will be the another winner. Draw when the game is draw. When will the game become draw? When no one is winning, the game becomes a draw. In that case, you need to return a draw. That means return a draw. Okay, he has given another output, invalid input. When the game inputs doesn't have valid characters. Okay, for this game, what are the valid characters? X, O and dot are the valid characters. Apart from these three kinds of data, if you give any other data, you should say that it is invalid data. Okay? Invalid input. Next statement is saying, invalid game, where the game data has valid characters but the game rules are not followed. What does this mean? What do you think is the rule for tic-tac-toe game? Okay, that means we have 9. That means the 3x3 grid. How many elements will be there in 3x3 matrix? 9 elements. In those 9 elements, when will a player A can win? That means there are 2 players, A and B. When you can say that player A is 1? 3 or more in the same direction. That means, I'll give an example. I made 3 moves and player B made 4 moves. Is that game going in a valid way? Is it following the rules of the game? Yes or no? Here is the game. 3x3 matrix. I am player 1. I played. Next player played. This is a valid point. Now again I made the move. Player 2-1. 2 played. Next again I made a move. The another player played the game and he won the game. That means between 2 players, when they make a move, what is the maximum difference they should have? 0 or 1. Or it should be 1. 1. If it is greater than 1, that means can I play 4 moves and that means Rajesh and Kranti are playing the game. Can Rajesh make 4 moves and Kranti make only 2 moves? No? Yes. Your data might have that situation where your game becomes invalid when this rule is not followed by the game based upon the given input. Okay? Remember this case also. Here are some examples. Here is a case where there are 2 winners. To represent 2 winners, he is specifying this. Another case where there are more than turns for X than O, or O has more turns than X. That means, how many number of turns does X have? 7. How many turns does O have? Does this follow the rule? In that case, you need to say that it is an invalid game. The data is valid, but it is not following the rules. Yes? This is your complete solution. Yes? Right, we go for the solution. Okay. What should we do here? That's my complete solution summary. Then how I should solve it? Directly take a matrix or follow the format? Yes, main method. I wrote main method, yes. Main method is done. Next. What should I do here? Okay, first I need to take the user input. First I'll check what is the input type is at all. Yes. Now this is my data. How should I read it? For I in range of 3. Will the range always be 3? Why? The game itself is a 3x3 matrix game. So you can statically say that, by confidently you can say that the maximum size it will have is 3 itself. Yes? Yes. Here can you say nim underscore rows equal to 3 and access that particular attribute here? Yes? Can you do that? In case, I'll make it global also. I can access it anywhere if I write a function also. Can I do that? Yes, okay. I made this for I in range of num underscore rows. Now, next, what should I do? Take user input. I took input. Where should I store it? User underscore input equal to input. Yes, I read the data. Next. What should I do with that data? What will be stored in user input right now? String of? The complete 3 rows or only 1 row? Initially when I iterate, for the first time when I is 0, it will be only first row. When I is 1, it will be the second row. When I is 2, it will be the third row. Yes? Okay. Now first I have this particular row. Now what should I do with the data? Okay, first what should I do? I should first store it into a matrix, right? What should be our first process? First, data is being given by the user to the program. In the program, I need to store the complete 3x3 matrix, right? After storing only, I can do the complete operation. Without storing, can I do all the operation? Can I perform only on the particular first row? I should first store whatever data is being given by the user. I should take it to the program, into the program. I should store it somewhere and then perform operations on it. Yes? Okay. First process is storing data. Now I got first user input. What should I do in the process of storing? I should convert it into a list. Okay, I'll say dot split off. I'll split by space. I splitted it. Next. Take another list. Where should I take? Above for loop? Yeah. Matrix is equal to list. Okay, I've done that. Matrix matrix dot append user input. Yes, done. Yeah, what do you all say? Is the matrix completely stored?
List of user.
List of. Now this will be in the form of, format of list itself, right? Yes, again, why to explicitly do it? Okay, I'll once check out whether I'm getting the complete matrix into the program or not. Okay, we have printed our data. Is this the right data? Yeah, once we go to our input file, if we check this, is the data correct? Dot x dot o o o dot x dot. Yes, now we are getting all the data into the program, right? Yes, now I am getting all the data. Next, what should I do? What should I perform here? What is the first thing that you have to do? Based on the given input. Now I got the input into the program. There are the following outputs. X or O. Yes? That means you need to find who is the winner. Should we write a separate function for that or write the code in this itself? Okay, separate function. What should we name it? Yeah? Winner. Okay. Winner. And? Okay. Game winner. Right? Now, should I call that particular function? Game underscore winner of matrix. I am passing an argument here, right? I need to catch it above also. Yes, with the same name I am catching above. Next, what should I do here? Game? Okay, now we have the matrix. Once again, we'll print our data here and see whether it is outputting. The same data is being outputting. Okay, this is the matrix. How can you say some player is winner? Okay, before going there, who will be the winner in from this matrix? O. Okay, how can you say the winner is O? Within a list? Okay, you told within a list, the element should be same. Which list? You have, okay, we'll consider this matrix as a two-dimensional list. Yes? Okay, which list you should consider? Okay, there should be an order, right? Okay, one second. Okay, I'll specify one thing. In a matrix, I'll have three rows. Yes? Okay, for a game, in this tic-tac-toe game, how can you say a player is a winner? That means the game has a matrix. Each matrix will have, if you consider into 2D list, each list will have 3 rows. That means elements in each row should be same. That is one case. What is another case? That means each row has how many columns? each row has three columns. That means the data in column 1 should be same, or data in column 2 should be same, or data in column 3 should be same. That is another condition. What is, are there any more possibilities where you can say diagonal? That means if you consider this is a matrix, 0 by 0 index position, you can say 1 by 1, 2 by 2, and another one is, is there any other possibility of making a game win? 0 to 1 1. Yes, that means what does 0, okay, I'll say in another way. 0 is the row, 2 is the column. Yes, 1 1 and 2 0. Yes, that means horizontal, vertical, diagonal from left to right, and diagonal from right to left. There are four possibilities, right? First we'll write for horizontal thing. Yes, now based upon the matrix given, I need to find who is the winner for only the horizontal condition. That means only rows I'll be checking. Yes, what code should I write for I in range of length of matrix? Okay, why do you take length of matrix? Yeah, number of rows. You globally define number of rows here, right? Can you make use of it? Yes, for I in range of num underscore rows. Next, if okay, 1 second. You wrote this for loop. What is the purpose for you to write this particular for loop? To get the each row. That means what does I have? Each row. That means, okay, in each row, how can you find out whether all the three elements are of same kind? Yeah, tell your ideas first. Yeah. Yeah, 1 second, Shishank will listen to us. Yeah. Okay, that is one case. She wanted to use list. Use set, append data into a set, and then check based upon the length. If the length is 1, then she will say that it is in one order. That means the elements in that particular row are of same kind. Yes, that is one condition. Shishank. For J in range matrix of, okay, that means you can write here also num underscore rows, right? Because it is a 3 by 3 matrix. Okay, this is another case. What you want to do here? Okay, what is your check condition for that? Matrix of I, J, you want to store it in the temp? Okay, there's some idea. I'll say count underscore x equal to 0. I'll say count underscore o equal to 0. I'll say if matrix of I of j equal to x, I'll increment my count x by 1. Yes? Yes? Else if equal to O, I'll increment count and score O by 1. Yes? Here what I'll do is
count of O equal to 3.
Yes. if count underscore x equal to 3, what should I do next? It will become 3, I think. Yes, 3. Then now what should I do? Print. Okay. Then after that, I printed x. Next after that? Else? Else if or only else? Elif. O. 1 second, I'll rename it. It is O only. Okay. Count underscore O. Equal to 3. Then what should I do? Print. O. Yes. Yes, his question is that what is this loop is for? You'll get row. Why are you using this loop for? You're accessing each column from the row. Yes? What will happen? For every row you'll be performing this. Yes? In that case, okay, you will be performing this, you'll be checking for all the conditions, was his question. That means there will be a situation where it might fail. You have dot. What will you do? Should we place our x and 0 values here itself? Okay, 1 second. I'll print values of count x and count x comma count o. Okay. I'll see the code. I made the call to game winner. Okay. What is happening here? This is my print statement at line number 12. The value is 10. Count of 1 in first row. What is the value of x count in row 1? 1. What is the count of 0? Oh, sorry, O? 0. Okay. In the second row, what is the count of x? It should be 0, but why is it 1? Count x? Yes, Shishank want to bring this count x. Only count x or count 0 also? Count o also. He want to bring both these two here. Why? What is the reason? Why you want to bring this both count underscore x and count underscore o? Yes. What you are checking for condition here to say that a player is a winner or not? You need to check for a row. All the elements in the row should be of same type. That means if x has all the three elements as x, then it should be the winner. That means for every row, are you updating the values to 0? Count of x and count of 0? That is the reason you got 1013 here. Here, if I again re-execute it, now you are getting the right values. What is the count of x in row 1? 1. The count of 0 in first row? 0. What is the count of x in row 1? 0. Count of o in row 2? 3. All the data is true, right? Yes. Here it printed o. Why did it print o? Winner is o. Yes. I am printing there itself. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. Can I remove this? and execute it once again? Did I get my output? I'll comment this also, and I will again execute it. Again re-executed. It outputted. It gave output as O. We'll once go to our output file and check whether it is our output. What is the output? O. That means it's correct, right? You got your data. Based upon the given input, you got your output. First condition is satisfied. Now, we'll check for the test case where you have other direction, that means vertical and diagonal. Okay, we had diagonal here. Should we go for diagonal or we should check for vertical? We'll see vertical, okay. This is also diagonal. This is also... Yes, should we go for test case 4? Yes, we'll open its output also. Input, output, okay. Now we again came here. Yes, should I write another function or should I write in this itself? Okay, now I'll write another function. First I'll write another function. In this itself you want to do. Okay, how can you solve it in here itself? Yeah, how you can solve here? Yeah, one thing coming in. I didn't.
The first row count is 1.
Okay.
So that 1 into some variable.
Okay.
And the second row also x is count is 1. We should store it in adder. If it is equal to 3, then x is the number.
Okay.
Vertically.
Vertically.
So we should store count into something.
That means we shouldn't override it. That means we are always making it 0 in our previous case.
Yeah, but count can be stored into a variable. That variable will not become 0.
Will not become 0. That means for every iteration we are making this 0 right here. In this case, in the previous program, for our previous program, we are making, it worked well. Only when we updated our count values to 0. But now you are saying we shouldn't update our count values to 0. Then how? For every row. Okay, one second. Think over here. For this row, what will be the value of x and 0? Okay, one second. I'll execute the code for this. This is test case number 4. Okay, before executing, I'll print the values of count. Print of count x, comma. Count O. Yes. One second. Yeah. This is your output. Whenever you are making your for every row you are making count of x 0. So you are getting here only 1. One second. Okay, where you want me to take A? A equal to 0. Okay. Okay, sorry. Yeah. A plus equal to count. Only count or count x you have, count O you have. Count underscore x, okay. Again, I should write another if condition. If A equal to 3, print x. Okay. Yes. Will that work? Yes. Should we execute the program? Okay. For this, you got your x. If I execute for the previous case, you are getting your data. One second. What is output 1? Okay, for output 1 also you are getting your data. Yes guys, should we go with this? Okay, you did not understand. One second. EN score X, I'll say. Okay. I'll make this as this. B underscore X. Sorry, B underscore O. Okay. B underscore O. B underscore O. Plus equal to count O. Yes? Okay. Right, before going to the code, from the given input, how will you find out? Okay, for this test case, what will be your, who will be the winner, X or O? X. Okay. How do you think you can access the values of X and make it a count to say that the X is the winner? Matrix of 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0. Okay, that means here what value is changing? The index position 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0. Row index is changing. Yes, every time your row index is changing. So here I took a variable called a underscore x equal to 0. Yes, in this row, every time when I go into, okay, one second. In this for loop, I am every time accessing each row. Every time my count of X and count of O are becoming 0, right? Every time when I get into the row. That means, in this loop, I am accessing through all the three columns in each row. When I go inside, I am updating the value of A underscore X with count underscore X. That means, it will give the maximum count of that particular row, right? Okay, have you understood this particular point, what I've told? That means here, I'll be there. One second. I'll execute it and I'll show. Yes. Here in the first stage. One second. Yeah, first test case is running. Fourth test case I'll run. Yeah, for the fourth test case, what is the value of X here? When I printed, these are X and O frequencies in each row. Yes? What is the frequency of X here? 1. This I am adding to A underscore X. A underscore X plus equal to count underscore X. Yes. That means if you say this dot is replaced with X, yes, what will happen in that case? Okay, here for example, that means one second. Instead of giving from the input, I'll give X, X, O. Yes? X, O, dot. Another X you want me to give? Okay, I give another X. X, dot, dot. Who should be the winner? In this case also you got X. Yeah, one second, I'll give another condition. If I say X space X space X. Yes? x space dot space O dot space x space O. Okay, okay, this test case also failed. 1 second. X. Yeah, guys. For the given input, what should it return? Will it form a what is will x be the winner or none, but it's printing x. Yeah, what should we do? Yeah, we'll write a separate function. Okay, that means what are the comments that we wrote? Okay, code that we wrote is this line, this line, these two lines. Yes, we'll remove off these two. Yes, here our test case one should pass. For that, O is the winner. Okay, O is the winner. Now again I'll go to test case two. Okay, can I say this as horizontal underscore winner? Can I name that function as horizontal underscore winner? Yes. Okay, I'll write another function saying def underscore vt underscore winner. Yes. Again, I'll pass matrix. For this case, what should I do again? Based upon the given input, x is the winner.
In that parameter, sir, can we use matrix of I J as another?
Okay, 1 second. For I in range, you all want me to write similar to that, yes? Num underscore rows. Again, for J in range of num underscore rows, yes? This. Now, what should I do? If matrix of J of I next equal to X. You want to increase the count. Okay, that means I need to write my count. Where should I write my counts? Here or in the loop? Here itself. Count underscore X equal to 0. Count underscore O equal to 0. Yes. Then in this case, what should I increment? Count underscore x equal to 1. Elif matrix of J of I equal to O. Count underscore O plus equal to 1. Yes, I have done this. Next, what should I do? Yeah. If count of x equal to 3, print x. Okay. Elif count underscore O equal to 3, print O. Yes. Will this work? Okay, I'll execute it. The test case is 4. It did not print anything. What happened? So I'll say here, I'll write else print high. It did not go to that kind. Okay, one second. First, did we call this function at all? Okay, I'll comment this out and I'll check vertical of matrix. Yes. Yes, it gave x as your, one second, is your output x? Yes, you got x. Here I have one doubt. For the given input, we are iterating through each
row first.
That means for every row I am making my x and o values 0, right? Every time I am making my x, count of x and count of o as zeros. But how is it working? Should it work? I'll print my print count underscore x comma count underscore o and I'll execute it once. Yes, first time itself I got the value as 3. Once I did not get it. Unable to see the code. Yes, does this work? Okay, here. How did this logic work? Ouch. Yes, how will it work? Yes, you all need to say, we have written the code, but how will it work? What are you saying here? Matrix of J of I. What value are we increasing here always? J value. So your I value is still 0. Your J value is starting from 0 to 2. That's how you are getting in the count of. Count as 3. That means your position is at 0 itself. That means row 0. You are saying, sorry, you are swapping your I position with J position. That means you are saying you are always increasing, actually you are increasing your column number, column index position. But you are giving that column index position to the rows. And you are replacing rows value with the column index position. Okay, did you get this point what I have told? In the previous code what we have done? Our row is matrix of I of J. That means we are checking for each column here. But whereas here matrix of J of I, what is it checking for? For the first column, it is checking always the 0th value.
Oh, sir, second column
is yes.
Second column is
for that also it works. Okay. What should I give? O space X. Dot x o O X dot. For this also it works. There is no problem in it. What I wanted is that you need to understand how it is working. That's it. Did you understand how it is working? Yes. Okay, here, can we make both these function as only one function? Can we merge? What is the only thing that we are changing here? Yeah. When we consider these two functions, how much code is different from one another? Only these particular statements, right? Yes. That means here, can I say, that means here when calling itself, I'll say pattern as another argument. I'll pass pattern as another argument. For that I'll say comma hz means horizontal, comma vt means vertical. I will replace this function with hz vt. Hz vt. I'll replace this function name with hz vt. One second. Hz vt. How many arguments am I passing? Matrix and the pattern type. That means horizontal I want to check or vertically I want to check. Among these two, which part? Only this block is changing, right? Here I'll say if pattern equal to hz, I'll keep this code like this only. Elif pattern equal to vt, I'll copy the code from above. This code is taken from here. I want to comment this code and I want to check for test case 4. Yes, test case 4. What is the output for test case 4? X. You got your data? Yes. Organizing your code. We'll check for input 1. What is the output for input 1? O. We'll execute our first one also. Oh, did we get our data? Yes. In the one function itself, we are performing both the operations. Yes. Okay, I'll leave it like that only. Next, what is the another format? How we can win a game? Diagonal. Okay, in this diagonal, should we write another function or should we use this only? We'll write another function first. Okay, I'll say def left to right underscore diagonal of matrix. I'm passing the argument. Okay. Here I'll say left to right diagonal of matrix. Yes. Now, okay, we'll open the test case which is in the diagonal format. I have first test case. For this input, you need to write your code. How can I find out? Okay, which will be the winner in this? O. O is the winner. Okay, how do I access those particular vertical positions? I? Okay, tell me the code. Yeah, okay, line by line, tell me the code, how to write it. For I in range, number of rows, for j in range, number underscore rows. Next, if I J okay, why we need to take that particular number? I equal to J equal to? Okay. I equal to? Equal to O. Sorry, O. How can you do that? Okay. What does this result in? Yes. Can you say boolean equal to O? Second, I have one more thing here. Okay, first I need to use the counts, right? Frequency I need to count. Count underscore x equal to 0. Count underscore o equal to 0. Yes. Here I'll say if matrix of I of j equal to x, I'll increase count underscore x plus equal to 1. Elif matrix of I of I again equal to O. Count underscore O plus equal to 1. Can I do this? Huh? Where 20? Sorry, it's not J, it is also I. Okay. This is also I. Okay, what happened here? That is x. X colon. Yes. Okay. Here, will I be able to access the elements? What? Okay. What will be my values? Value of I here? First iteration, it is 0. Here, I am saying matrix of 0 of 0 equal to x. Or matrix of 0 of 0 equal to O. Next time my I value becomes 1. Matrix of 1 of 1. Matrix of 1 of 1 equal to X or 1 of 1 equal to O. When again I am increasing my I value by 1. Matrix of 2 of 2 equal to X or 2 of 2 equal to O. By that I can perform the operation, right? I am getting the values. Okay. If count of x equal to 3, print, what should I print? X. Okay. Elif count of o equal to 3, print of O. Yes. Will this work? Yes. What is the input number? This is input number 1. Input 1. Is it giving you a value O? Yes. This is one diagonal. This case is also done. What is the next case that you have? Right to left diagonal. Yes, should we write another function for this? Okay, right. Should we write another function here? Def right to left transpose diagonal of matrix of colon. Yes. And again I'll make a function call here. Right to left underscore diagonal of matrix. Yes. Okay, I came here. How should I perform this operation? Yeah, how should I perform for this? How can I say X is the winner? Okay, from the given input, who will be the winner? X only. Okay, 1 second guys, I'll close this once and again I'll open it. Okay. Who will be the winner here? X. Okay. In order to make the winner, okay, from the data, X is the winner. How will you access those elements actually? Right. If matrix of, okay, 0, 2 is equal to x and you should, okay, can you perform your operations like them? Yes. Okay, you'll write this code. Will you get marks for that? Huh? Okay, test cases are passed. Test cases will be passing. There is no problem in it at all. If you have 1000 test cases, you will write for 1000 test cases. There is no problem in it. But is it the way that you have to write your code? That is the point. Yes, we might come. Okay. Yeah, tell your code. For I in range of number of rows. Next. For j equal to name underscore rows minus 1. Yes. What I'll do, if matrix of I and j double equal to x, before that I need to increase, I should get the count of x and count of o. Yes, I'll do that. Count x plus equal to 1. Elif matrix of I j equal to O. Count O equal to 1. Here I'll reduce my j value by 1. And I'll write my code. Write the same code above. What is the test case number for this? Test case number 2. Did you get your output? X. Your answer is X. You got away? Yes. How did we solve it? I'm taking to j equal to num underscore rows. What is the value of num underscore rows? 3. That means 3 minus 1, 2. That means it is the last index position of any list, right? Any row element. Yes? I took count of x and count of o as 0. I went into the loop. Now my I value is 0. 0 matrix 0 of 2. Am I accessing the last element in the first row? Yes. Now I iterated, I came down. I reduced my j value by 1. My j value is 1 and my I value will be? I will also be 1. Matrix of 1 of 1. Again I reduce my j value by 1. 0. J is 0. I value is 2. Matrix of 2, 0 is x. You got the count of x and you printed this. Yes? You got your output? Yes. Now we okay. Is there any way where we can organize these diagonals into one function? Yes? No. No way. Yes or no? Okay, what are the differences in this particular line? Okay. Yeah, what is the difference in the code from above and down? You tell me. Here you have only high, you have j here. Yes? That is the only difference. So here, I'll pass my argument saying, comma, left to right. First, I'll rename my function. I'll rename my LR underscore diagonal by LR underscore left to right, right to left underscore diagonal. I replaced it. Okay, done. Comma, I want to check for left to right condition. I have done that. Next, I want to check for right to left. Okay? Yes, I came here. Here, I'll say pattern. My pattern. If pattern, I'll initialize j equal to 0 initially. If pattern equal to left to right, I'll say j is still equal to 0. Else if pattern, one second, equal to right to left, I'll say j equal to num rows minus 1. What do you all say? Yeah? Yeah, what will happen in this case? Okay, what is the difference between above and down? Here only we initialize j equal to num underscore rows minus 1. When right to left, I am doing the same operation here also, right? Yes. Okay. Apart from that, instead of writing there, I'll write if pattern equal to left to right, this code will be executed. Elif pattern equal to right to left, I'll copy code from above. 1 second. Okay, let me complete this. Again, we'll come up. Can I do this?
Yes.
Yes. I'll comment this code out. Yes. J. Yes, I'll say J equal to numRows minus 1. Yes. I'm not accessing J in this particular loop, but I'm accessing it here. Okay. Pattern. The naming convention is not right. Pattern. Right, okay. For test case 2, what is the output? X itself. Yes. For test case 1, what is the output? O. For test case 1, what is the output? O. You got your data. Yes. Now we wrote a code for to check who is the winner. From now X or O, for both the conditions we have written, to check in a row, to check columns, to check diagonally from left to right, to check diagonally from right to left. Yes. Now what should we do next? Before going any further, 1 second, I have one doubt. Here in the main function, I am just calling like this. Does this work if I write like this? Does it work like this? Okay, that means if I run eval, will it work properly? Should I execute eval? Yes. Okay. Eval, tic tac. Yes, should I print? I should be returning. Yeah, that's what I'm asking. Should I run it or not? Okay. How many test cases are passed? 8 by 14. Okay. Now 8 by 14 test cases are passed. 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, till 4. Okay, we'll make count of which test cases did not work. Okay, right. For test case 8, it is printing so many number of X's. Invalid, for invalid and draw we need to, okay, right. 1 second. First we'll note which test cases are failing. Okay. Test case 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 13. Yes. How many test cases do we have? 14. 8 passed, that means these should be 6. Okay, these are 6. First we'll open test case 5. What is test case 5? This is a matrix. What is the output of test case 5? Draw. Why it should be draw? Yes. Why it should be draw? No one is winning. Yes. Okay. We had written 2 cases here. How can we print draw here? Okay, first we'll check for the horizontal and vertical condition. Should we say else print draw? Yes. Should we do that or not? Okay, I'll write above also. I wrote above. Yes, I wrote here also. This is input 5. For input 5, I'll check for input 5. How many times is it printing? Okay, you are getting your output, but how many times it's printing?
8 times.
Why is that? Why is it printing 8 times? Okay, I have one question here. Here, for every given input, should you execute all the cases? For every input. Okay, you don't know. The first test case is passed in horizontal underscore vertical underscore winner itself. Then why you should execute the same condition again? Yes. Yeah. Okay. My point is, can we do this or not? Can we execute all the 4 at a time? No. Okay. At what condition can we execute the another condition? That means another question. Okay. Okay. Is there a way where we return a true or false from here? That means what I'm saying is, I'll say result equal to, for example, I'll call this function. This function should return whether the game is fair. That means it should say, that means a particular hand has won. That means it should return the value of x as well as it should return true. How can I do that? In the return, okay, instead of print, I'll say return. Return true. Okay, here also you want to say return true. For draw also, should I return true? Yes, I have done this. Next, what should I do? If result equal to false, which should execute, this is removed. Next, should I write all these 3 here? Again, how should I write it? Okay, I wrote my if condition here. Yes. After this, what should be my next statement? You tell me. Okay. Inside the if loop itself?
Inside
if, what should I write? Oh no. One second. Yeah, here you have result equal to this complete line. I need to do here. Yes, I have done. Next, again, should I check if result equal to false? Okay, one second. Result equal to again this particular operation. Okay, again if else where you want to write, here you want to write else. Yes, result equal to, yeah, would it work? What do you all say, would it work or not? Should we execute the for this particular case? Yes, it worked well, it printed only once. Now I will once again execute eval, eval tic-tac-toe.py. Now you are getting only two test cases passed. Previously it was 8. From 8 you got reduced to 2. What should we do? Yeah, what should we do? Okay, 1 second, yes. For test case, okay, from test case 0 will come. For test case 0, 1 second. Okay, we wrote this for this, but did we write for these also written true? We did not write for these cases, right? Okay. Return true, return true, return true. Yes. Again, I'll execute it. Now it will come to 2 or more, we'll see. The same case. Yeah. What should we do? The same situation here also. We got only 2. It's giving draw as your answer. Okay, we'll stop. Again, we'll resume after 4. After 5. Okay? Okay, right. As we have seen, what is the error that we have got? When we had done operation with this, we got 2 by 14. Then how should we solve it? This is the condition you all have told. Then how should we solve it? Yeah. How do you all think we should solve it?
So
only test case 0 you want me to execute? Okay, in this, okay. Right, it is written in draw. That means it is going to the else part. Yes. Okay, should I really go to the, okay. That means, should I really return draw there? That means there will be a possibility where there is no game. That means these conditions are not satisfied. Then there would be a possibility of returning a false also. When there will be a possibility of returning false? Okay, why are we returning true here actually? Whenever we are calling the function. Yeah. Okay, we'll go there. But what is the reason? Now, before statements are not being executed right now, right? Previously, I got 8 by 14. Now I am getting only 2 by 14. Then? Where? This? That means you need to execute one by one test case. You want to execute 0? So you are getting draw 1 by 0. Okay. If I remove this else condition, would it work? Okay. We'll see that. Okay. Got this. Yes, I got O. I'm removing the print statement and again executing eval. How many will be passing? 3 by 14 are passing. Yeah, in both the only there are two functions. These are commented. I organize the code. We organize the code. Yes, that means we have written here code here. We need to organize this code, I think then. Should we? Or should we not? Then what should we do? I'm going backward, that means removing few of the statements. I'll move to the stage where we executed all the 4 at once. I'm executing right now. Now I again got 8 by 14. Yes? Yeah, for test case 13, it's printing both. Okay, we'll see that condition later. For test case 8, it is printing all the 8 elements. Before that, we'll see. Test case 5, it is printing nothing. Why? For test case 5, what should be the output? It is expecting a draw. Okay. In this case. Okay, when will it be a draw? Okay, when we go for try and accept actually? We have a try block and a accept block. Yes, are we getting any error here? Yes. Yes. Okay, once we'll go for test case 5, right? We'll go, yeah, one second. We'll do that, yeah. Here, that means for this, what should it return? Draw means here itself you can return print else. Okay, right? Else print of draw draw. Okay, right. I have a case where I don't want to get multiple times. So what I'll do is, I'll say flag and score x is equal to false. Here I'll say flag and score o equal to also false. If this condition, that means if count underscore x equal to 3, I'll say flag and score x equal to true. In the same way, if count underscore o equal to 3, I'll say flag underscore 0 equal to true. After coming out of the loop, this is the loop, right? after coming out of the loop, I'll say if flag and score x, this would be enough, right, if it is true? If flag and score x would be enough, right? Elif flag and score o means I'll say print of o. Else I'll say print. Yes, would it be enough? In the code, okay. Yes. Yeah. If yes, it will not work. Here also I'll write, here only one else condition I'll write here. Else print of draw. Yes, I'll come here and I'll execute only the test case 5. It printed my draw statement 5 times. Why do you think it printed my draw statement 5 times? Yes, here I am executing all the 4 functions at a time. Then how can I restrict it? Here, instead of printing my data here, can I return this particular data as well as true? That means horizontal underscore vertical underscore winner, I'm calling that particular function. If there is a winner, it should return true as well as it should return who is the winner. It will return both the values. Okay, that means here I'll say return of, I wanted return two values. How can I return two values? Yeah, I want to return two values from a function. How can I return two values from a function? Tuple. Yes, I can use tuple to return two values. I'll say true comma x whenever I call the function. Here when I'm calling, I'll say result, I'll say result list equal to so and so. I'll convert the tuple to list here. Understood? This particular function is returning a tuple to me. So I'm converting it to a list here. After that, I'll say if result list of 0, that means it will be true, right? Result list, result underscore list will be true. If it is true, I'll say print of result list of 1. Will it work? Yes, it does work or it doesn't work? It works or not?
Yes.
Yes. In the same way, can I say again result list equal to, can I replace, can I call this function here? Again convert this also into a list and I perform the operation. And can I say, can I copy this code and replace over there? Yes. In the same way again, can I say result list equal to, again I'll call this particular function, again I'll convert this into a list, again I'll execute the same code, again I'll say result list equal to
first.
I'll tell you for that also. I'll tell you for that also. One second. Okay, I've written this. Your question is, here I'll print and I'll just return true.
Yeah. That is main function, bro.
Yes, me in the main.
If result underscore list of 0 in the printer as
well. Yes.
Akada return as the ipo dhira. Mali angi run over. Oboe hard.
Okay, where you want me to return? To the main function? Yeah, one second. Here after, okay. Here I wrote for everything. But here also I should return the same kind of data, right? Return of, tuple of, true, comma, O. Yes? Here also I'll say return tuple of, true, comma, draw. The same thing I'll do above also. Yes or no? Return tuple of true comma x. In this case I'll return O. In this case I'll return draw. Yes? I'll come to my statement and I'm executing this. What is happening here? Okay. It is still performing the same operation. Okay. One second. Sorry. Yes, now it's working. Yeah, we can return empty. That means you are returning from here to the main function. To here. From here you are making the call. You will go to the main function. Yes? Yeah? Draw. It's returning draw only for the fifth test case. Okay, where you haven't understood? Okay, for example, here when I perform this operation, it went to the function and it returned true, comma, draw. So I came into this, when I check this, it is true, right? I'll go into the if condition. I'm printing draw. After draw, what I'm saying return. What will happen? From this function, it moves to the function from where this call has made. So it come back still here. That's how it will print only once. Yes. Now we'll execute eval and see how many test cases will be passed. Now only 4 are passed. Okay. What happened again? Only 4 came into existence.
Only draw.
For the test case 2, it is saying draw. Yes? Sorry, for the test case 1, it's saying draw. What is the reason? We'll check once. For test case 1, in this case, your answer should be O. But it is returning draw. Why is that? left to right. Horizontal LR. Okay. When is it printing? Yeah guys, where is it throwing the error? If I only execute test case 1, it is returning draw. 1 second. No, I have commented it only in one function. So it is going horizontal underscore VT underscore matrix. Okay, actually this has to be false. In that case, how will you print and draw? Yes. Yeah, 1 second guys. Here, when you will be printing draw, what is the condition at which you need to print draw? When nobody wins. Yes. In that case, for this particular function, is it forming left to right, right, in this, is it forming a, are we getting a winner here? No. So we will return false here. At the end, what I'll do is print, if these 4 cases are not being executed, it comes down by default and it will say draw, and at the end I'll return. If we come back here and execute our test case 2, it gives us 0. What happened is, here as we returned true, it is going inside and it is stopping there itself. It's not going and checking for the winner actually. Okay, did you all understand this particular step what I have done? Yes? When should we return draw? When we did not find a winner, we should return draw. Then in that case, this should be false, right? That's what we have done. We made them false and we have done this. Here I am executing my... Yes, I return that also false. Now we'll check, yes. If you check here, 9 by 14 are the test cases passed. That means that draw test case, what was the draw test case? Test case 5. If you check, draw test case is also executed properly. There is no problem with it at all. Yes? Okay? Okay. From our list, our 5th test case is removed. Now what are the test cases that we have to check for? Invalid input. That means we have to go for input 6. What does input 6 have? When will be the data invalid?
Other than 0x.ox.
Ox dot, it should be invalid. That means we will write a function here saying def data underscore validation. Yes? I'll pass a matrix to this. Yeah. How to check whether data is valid or not? How can I check?
List of it, if you don't have a matrix.
Okay. Valid underscore data equal to, I'll say x comma o comma dot. Yes. How should I iterate? For I in matrix, for j in, for j in matrix of 0 or matrix of I would be enough. What will be present in I? Each row will be there. Now from each row I want to get each column. Yes, I'll get right. If j not in valid data, I will directly return false. Yes, if it is not false, if the data is valid, I'll come till the end and I'll return true. Okay, before that what I'll do here is I'll say, yes, that's what we need to write. If of matrix, if the data is valid, then I'll say this should be executed. Else, what should I print? Print invalid input. Yes. Yeah, it is sixth test case. It's invalid input. Yes. And return. I'll execute only the sixth test case. Sixth test case only, no? I got my answer. Yes. I'll execute again eval right now. We should get 10 by 14. Yes, we got a 10 by 14. We'll go to the test case 6. Did we get a test case 6? Invalid input. Yes. That means from the list we can remove our 6th test case also. Now we have to go for 7th test case. What does 7th test case have? Yeah, what does 7th test case have? How many X's does this particular matrix have? 6. How many O's does it have? 3. That means, what should it do? Invalid game. It should return invalid game. That means, you have valid data, but it is not following the rules of the game. Yes or no? Yes? So what you should do? Again, you need to write a function saying def game underscore validation. Here also I'll send the matrix. Here how should I calculate?
Divide between x and count of x and row, 1 and w. Or O and x should be 1 and
w. Okay, that means we need to first calculate how many number of x's are there, how many number of o's are there. Count x equal to 0. Count O equal to 0. Okay, sorry. O equal to 0. Now, for I in matrix, for J in matrix, J in I, sorry. Yes? J in I. If J equal to X, I'll say count underscore X equal to 1. Elif j equal to o, I'll say count underscore o plus equal to 1. After coming out, if what should I say? Count underscore x minus count underscore o should be equal to 1.
Or vice versa.
Yes. Instead of that, can I say absolute of Yes? Can I use absolute over there? What does absolute do? It converts negative to positive, so you'll get the same value, right? Then in that case, you will return true. Else you will return? Yes? Is that enough? What zero, ma'am? I think it will not be a valid data. How many points do you have? In a 3x3 matrix, how many elements do you have? 9. Split them to 2 players. How many they should become? 5 and 4. That means either... Okay, for example. I played 2 moves and he played 2 moves. Can the game be completed? Okay, we'll go for the test case next. First, we'll go for the game rules. Now, you played two positions. I played 2 positions. Yes? Can the game be completed? When will the game be completed? Okay, that is the worst case. We'll not go for that. We'll see. Where you made 3 moves, I made 2 moves. Then only you will become the winner, right? Or you made 3 moves, I made 4 moves. Then only I will become the winner. For example, you made 3 moves, I made 3 moves. Would it become a winner? It wouldn't, right? Yes or no? There will be a difference of only 1, not 2, not 0, right? That means after me making 3 moves or you making 3 moves, the win will not be happen, right? Does it happen? Yes, that's what we are doing there. Okay. If you want to say less than or equal to 1, for your satisfaction, should we go with that? Okay, we'll go with that. Here, okay, we have written this particular condition of game underscore validation. Where should we call it? In the main method. Okay, we came to main method. After that, after coming to main method, where should I call it? Data is validated, but after data validation, is game wrong is happening or?
After data validation,
you need to perform this. Okay. I'll tell you another example. Your data is valid, but your... Okay, first, what is happening? They are giving you a gameplay itself. That means so many operations are... They are giving you... This is how a player played, 2 players played. For this, you need to calculate the result. Okay? For that, first, what you need to check, whether the gameplay is correct or whether the input is correct.
Yeah.
What do you all say? What should we check first? Should we check first for the gameplay or for the input? Okay, when do you say a game is valid or not? First, it should follow the rules or not? Then in that case, first, which condition should you check? Game condition or data validation? Game validation or data validation?
Game validation.
Game validation you need to check. So, I'll say, if game validation of matrix, if it is true, I'll keep everything in if. If it is else, I should print. Print of invalid game. Yes. And I'll return it. I'll execute only one test case. Which test case did it fail? Test case 7, right? For test case 7, I'll check invalid game. Yes, I'll open my output of 7. What is it returning? Invalid game. What is your test case 7 input? Is your data valid here? That means, okay, the data is valid, but is the game valid? The game is not valid. When you executed, have you got your answer? Yes? Then should we execute eval? Should we go for eval or not? Eval. Tic-tac-toe game. What is happening? 12 by 14 only. It is saying 12 by 14. Which test case are failing? 6th and 13th. Okay. First we'll go for 13th test case. Why did 13th test case fail? We'll go for the input once and check. Yeah, why did it fail? What is the count of 3? What is the count of X here? What is the count of O here? 3. Is it a valid game? Yes, that is the wrong input that you need to say. I played the game like that. I have given the input. Yeah, that's what they have given you the condition saying. Okay, if this kind of data is given, you need to give output as invalid game. They are telling you to do that. You don't want to do that. What we should do? Yeah? As he placed here less than condition, it failed. Should we place equal to and executed?
Equal to better or failure condition?
It will not.
One layer.
What is the difference? Okay, what is the count of X? What is the count of O? What is the difference of both? What is your condition here? What you are saying here? It should be equal to 1. Then only your game is valid. Yes? Now we got another condition. Our 6th test case is failed. How should we do? Sixth test case you want to open, okay. Sixth input, sixth output is invalid input. What did it return for us? Invalid game. But what should it be? Input. That means he is first checking for the input itself. I have misguided you all. He is first checking for the input. Then he is going for the game whether... Okay, we will check that condition and then we will conclude whether it works or not. Yeah, one second. We'll see what is working and what is not working. The 6th test case, right? Okay, we'll execute eval again and we'll see. No, it's not. All the other test cases are failing. This is correct that we have done previously. But what should we do? What is it doing here? Yes, it is going to, that means it is combination of both. Data is invalid as well as this also is invalid. So, in that case, if you write AND condition here, One second. Here previously we just only swapped these elements. One second, give me a minute. Yes, first it is checking for data validation. I told you wrong in the beginning, that means I assumed it wrong way. First it is checking for the data, whether if the data is valid, then only it is going inside the game. Then afterwards again it is checking for the game validation also. Again if the game is also valid, then only it is going inside and performing the operations. That's how you are getting your result, final output. Right? Understood?